How y'all doing? This is Harris Decker from the Truth About Music, truthaboutmusic.com, and this is our second video podcast. Last week, we brought you some new music that we really liked. We brought you a new song by Travie McCoy called Dillionaire, as well as a few others. This week, we're back with some less than stellar news. We had a great week of music last week, tons of new stuff, and this week was just not a good week for new music for us. So instead of bringing you our top three songs of the week, we're going to give you three songs that we think should not ever be played again and should have never been written to begin with. The first song we're going to begin with, the first song we're going to give you is by an artist called Spose. I'm pretty sure that's the pronunciation. It's S-P-O-S-E. He wrote a song called I'm Awesome, and I don't really want to give you much preface on this. I just want you to listen and let me know.
Motherfucker, I'm awesome. No, you're not, dude. Don't lie. I'm awesome. I'm driving around in my mom's ride. I'm awesome. A quarter of my life gone by, and I met all my friends online. Motherfucker, I'm awesome. I will run away from a brawl. I'm awesome. There's no voicemail, nobody calls. I'm awesome. I can't afford to buy eight balls, and I talk to myself on my Facebook wall. You know my
pants. So Spose is Ryan Peters. That's his Spose's stage name. He's from Maine, and this is him rapping.
And lyrically, I'm not the best. Physically, the opposite of Randy Moss, and yet so preposterous. Feel the awesomeness. The most obnoxious guest up at the sausage fest. Oh yes, the girls are repulsive.
He just uses a lot of very cheap raps, very just bland rhymes, things that are just not. You know, he's trying to be funny, and I guess I understand that, but there's just very little of this song that's actually interesting. I mean, it goes on for, you know, over 3 minutes, and you're hoping that it's going to end almost immediately when it starts. I mean, you can tell by the chorus, I'm awesome, no you're not, dude, don't lie. It's kind of a very, like, you know, it sort of takes what 303 was trying to do about a year ago, and it just makes it bad. I mean, 303 did it well. Spose not doing it well. Second song we're going to bring you this week that you should stop listening to immediately is, unfortunately, I really hate to say this, is from Jack Johnson. Jack Johnson has his, I don't even know what number album this is, but his album To the Sea, coming out at the very end of May, the last day of May, and this is the first single off it. It's called You and Your Heart. And what I really hate is that every time Jack Johnson puts out a song, I want to love it. And usually I do. This one, I don't. There's just something about it. He uses a very, very boring, chord structure, and the lyrics just aren't very creative. Let's take a listen. So as you can see here, this is just a very boring opening. There's nothing, the chord structure is so simple that it doesn't do Jack Johnson justice.
What you when you say, what you are when you blame everyone. You broken king. What you change the frame or what you when you take your aim.
This verse just doesn't do anything for me, and then he hits the chorus here.
You and your heart shouldn't feel so far apart. You can't choose what you take. Why you gotta break and make it feel so hard?
What I hate is that I really wanted to like that song. I heard it and it almost got there. It's very close to being a good song. It just, something about it at the very end just really just doesn't, he doesn't put it together. I mean, there's, you know, he almost gets to the hook in the chorus, and then it just ends up being a very cheap, like, kind of boring hook. I sort of wish he had gone somewhere else with that chord structure, or the chord progression, rather. You know, I don't want to put down his new album because, you know, I'm hoping it's going to be great. He's put out some great things in the past, in the last few years. But that song really doesn't give me much hope. The last song I'm going to give you comes from... This is probably my least favorite song, actually, out of these three bad songs. It's from Selena Gomez. She is the actress from Wizards of Waverly Place, which is a Disney Channel show. She's been in a bunch of different, very children's-based programming. And she's put out two CDs. A few singles. For some reason I can't count how many CDs she's put out, but her newest song is dreadful. I mean, there's really nothing in it that's good. It features a band called The Scene, and I'm gonna let you give it a listen, and you can make your own judgment. I think this is one of the cheapest choruses we've ever heard. I mean, everything comes naturally. It's a very, it's very, very boring, I think. This is sort of an example of where Disney did not get it right. I mean, I think they've done some decent stuff in the past, you know. I don't think they totally screwed up the Jonas Brothers attitude, you know. They sort of had a base because they were a band before Disney. Selena Gomez, I can't really speak for. I can't, I would imagine she's not quite in that same position. This seems like a very forced effort from Disney. Unfortunately, the song's getting some decent radio play. I'm hoping they scale it back in the next, month. But the song is, you know, getting some play, and, I hope that this, music like this is not the future of music. There's a lot of good music out there right now, so I think it's, you know, I think we're in a pretty good position, but, this song's pretty dreadful. So sorry to be such a downer this week, but those are three songs that I think you should avoid at all costs. I'm Harris Decker from The Truth About Music. It's truthaboutmusic.com. You can follow us on Twitter at Truth About Music. You can find us on YouTube, YouTube/Truth About Music, and we hope to see you there.